Hello and welcome back to our course. This is the first lesson of the Measure module. It is dedicated to monitoring your campaign and adjusting your strategy. In this lesson, we will learn how to use position tracking to monitor the progress of your rankings on search engines. To do this, we will use the data picked out from the Keyword Magic tool. Position tracking allows you to monitor you and your competitors' organic and paid Google rankings for a list of keywords you've selected and to manage them in several ways. First, let's set up the position tracking tool. Go to your projects list and then select position tracking. In the setup menu, choose what you want to track: a root domain, a subdomain, a URL, or a subfolder. We recommend that you begin with setting a root domain for tracking and then narrow your tracking scope later. By setting a specific URL, you will get the results exactly matching this URL, so you need to be sure that this is the URL you want to track. You can change the tracking scope at any time, and all the data, including the historical data, will be updated right away. Setting up your business name will help you see the locations where you succeeded with getting into local packs. It is important in case your business is focused on certain locations. Unlike the Semrush Domain Analytics Report, which provide data on the national level, position tracking allows you to track rankings for a specific location. You can monitor your rankings on desktop and mobile SERPs by setting up projects for different targeting. Guru and business subscribers can streamline their SEO efforts by merging their projects in a multi-targeting project later on. This can be done in the Devices and Locations report. If you select a multilingual country, like Canada or Belgium, where Google performs searches in different languages, you will be able to choose the desired language. Next, add up to 20 competitors to compare your rankings to. They can be either added manually or selected from a suggested list. Finally, choose keywords for your tracking campaign. You can add them manually, receive suggestions based on Semrush's organic or paid positions report, receive suggestions from your Google Analytics account, or import them from a file. You can also add more keywords whenever you want. It may take a few minutes to half an hour for position tracking to gather the data for your project. This depends on the number of keywords you wish to track. Once the report is gathered, you will jump to the position tracking overview page. There you will find the visibility trend of your website. Visibility is a metric that reflects how visible your domain, subdomain, or URL is for the list of keywords you've set up. 100% visibility means that the tracked domain, subdomain, or URL has the first position for every keyword in the project, while zero visibility indicates that it doesn't rank in Google's top 100 for these keywords. You can analyze how your competitors succeed in ranking for the keywords of interest by seeing which domain has the highest visibility metric. Also, keep an eye on the estimated traffic and average positions metrics. Estimated traffic is a calculation that predicts how many people will visit the domain daily from the keywords being tracked. Average position is the average of all the rankings for the keywords in your campaign. An increase in your domain's estimated traffic, as well as its average position rise, indicates that you are making progress in your SEO. You can compare up to 5 domains from your competitor list by these metrics at the same time. The Ranking Distribution Report allows you to find out who attracts more attention by comparing your domains and your competitors' domains' visibility and estimated traffic, see the number of keywords in the campaign you and your competitor have in the top 3, top 10, top 20, and top 100 positions. The rankings report provides you with data on your ranking and your competitor's ranking for every keyword you've set up in the campaign. The report is organized as a table with a list of keywords. Every competitor you add for comparison is represented as a column of data. The landing pages report shows you the landing pages of the selected domain that rank for the list of the campaign's keywords. Here you can find the distribution of estimated traffic and total volume between the pages and their average positions. The competitor's discovery report will help you find out who you are competing with for your target audience. It is a good place to find your competitors because it discovers them based on your list of keywords. You can see the domains that compete with you for keywords in the top 3, 5, 10, 20, 50, or 100 results of Google. The Featured Snippets report will help you find the opportunities to get a featured snippet position, see the keywords your domain already ranks for in a featured snippet. Furthermore, it estimates how much traffic you might gain in case you win a featured snippet. You can also set up alerts triggered when a certain event takes place and get the summary of your progress via email every week. Just a reminder, in this lesson, we've learned about the position tracking tool. It allows you to observe your SEO campaign in comparison with your competitors. We advise you to play around with position tracking because practice makes perfect. Also, don't forget to consult the Read Further section and visit the Semrush blog and knowledge base.